Well, we just received a big donation from the food bank. Food is always welcome at any homeless shelter, but here in particular, we've got quite a few people who wait for a delivery of food coming, then get stuck in, it makes their day, and we're thankful to the food bank for everything they do for us. Support in Stoke-on-Trent from the public is just fantastic. If it wasn't like that, we wouldn't be here today in our new building. We've come from a very small enclosed place about 50 or 60 yards down the road to this massive warehouse where we've put, as you can see behind me, we put pods in for people to live in. Most of the people who stay in there take a great deal of pride in their home now, and they actually do call it their home, because before they didn't have anything on the streets or sofa surfing, but they've come here now and take a great deal of pride in what they've got, look after the place, clean it most of the time. Of course, there's the odd occasion they don't look after it, and we've got to remind them that they've got to do it. So we've come from a small place and made great progress to where we are today with the help of everyone. I've got to say, especially the food bank, who have looked after us since I started about 3.5 years ago. They've always been there for us, and we're there for them as well. We make a donation every year to them, and I know it's well appreciated.
So they've all got a telly, got a laundry there, which we employ a laundry man who's came over to pass that room. These ones here are completely, these have got a...
I found in my time working with homeless people, there's two things in particular you can do to help them, which is get them in a safe place, which is one, which this is, and feed them. Those are two things that are vital. Everybody needs fed, so it's no different for anybody that's homeless. They need fed as well, and they need to be safe, because when they're on the streets, unfortunately, they can be sleeping in the doorway, people can come along late at night, especially the weekend when the pubs and clubs were open. Stand on them, do whatever, spit on them. All these things are a possibility, so when they come in here and we lock the door at 10 o'clock, they know they're safe, they know they're warm, and they know they're going to get fed. So we're delighted that we've been able to do that for about 3.5 years, and we're continuing to do it now. Under much better circumstances, with a building that, got to be honest, we're all, and myself in particular, we're all proud of, we're all delighted to be here, and we hope we can continue a service to the people that are here and get them back on track, get them back into a normal routine in life, which is the hardest thing. That is the most difficult thing. We can feed them easily, we can look after them easily in the pods here. But getting them back on track and getting a life in front of them, for them to leave here, go out, find opportunities, get a job, pay the bills, find a partner or whatever else which is normal, to do that is the toughest job of all. But we're here to try and achieve that, and if we do, great, if we don't, we keep going.